unplug everything here. The colon plugs first. Four. Okay, now the injectors. Okay, we're gonna do the left side. We're gonna use an 8mm ratchet, a wrench. Remove this bolt first. Okay, this little fastener goes on the fuel rail. That's the first one out of two. The second one is right here. As you can tell, it's really hot in Texas. I'm sweating like a pig. There you go, second fastener. Now I can pull on the fuel rail. Lots of gas is flowing off it, it's coming off, but that's all right. Okay, I'm gonna wash all this with pressured air. Make sure everything's clean so nothing falls into the spark plug holes. Then next step is to unplug the colon plugs. You need a little an 8mm socket. I mean, no, that's a 7 and a ratchet. They're really easy to remove. Okay, those are fasteners you do not want to lose. Just pull the colon plug straight up. That's what it looks like. There's lots of dirt around it. So use air again and keep it here. I'm gonna do one at a time so that I don't get confused or anything. Some more air. Now I have access to the spark plug. Okay, here we go again. So we got one hole that's uncovered right here. The new spark plug is gonna go in. Let's remove the one that's in there right now. Special spark plug socket, 5/8, with a little rubber grommet and an extension right here. And easy. Be very careful, you don't want to damage the threads. So make sure the whole ratchet and extension are aligned. Even take the ratchet off for the end. So you can just do it by hand. Alright, I got it. So the spark plug really wasn't that bad. It was a Motorcraft Platinum, and what I bought was I think Motorcraft Platinum 2 also. SP493, I think they're the same. Same as what I bought. They look a little different though. What is wrong with this? I'm gonna put them on anyway. I don't care. I built this little paper tube so I can go all the way down into the spark plug hole and blow some air down in there, because on top of the spark plug threads there's a lot of sand and dirt that I saw. I thought it was gonna be clean, but it's not, so damn it. I think it did the trick. Okay. So see, the colon plug fits right on top of the spark plug, like that. Just making sure everything's smooth. Torque it hard, but not too hard. Okay. And the other spark plugs are basically the same thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the other ones. And then I just put the colon plug back on. Like that. Right there. I can already put a fastener back on. Alright, that should do it. No, maybe a little more. So that it doesn't move. It moves anyway. Okay, and I will reconnect it just like that, so now I know that it's been done. Let's move on to the other ones. Like before, you pull up on the colon plug, make sure it's clean, and take the other one, the next spark plug off. Alright, so when you're done with all the spark plugs, and you put on all the colon plugs and all the connections, make sure the fuel rail is placed right on top of all the injectors, those yellow injectors. Everything seems to be all right. Wiggle the fuel rail a little bit. Make sure all the injectors are good. Placed all right, then you put the fasteners back on top of the fuel rail. Use the eights to fasten them. Done with this side.